Hey everyone, Foundation Afro back here again, talking about Halo 4, Forward Unto Dawn, Part 2. And this week, I even wrote notes while I was watching the video, so I will have hopefully better things. I don't know if I have more things to say, I think I have fewer things to say than last week. But I will have maybe better things to say. And again, if you haven't seen the video yet, spoiler warning, and I will put a link in the description below, so watch that before you watch this. I think my favorite part of the video was the fact that Frank O'Connor is a janitor at this facility where all these kids are being trained, and I thought that was awesome and hilarious, so I just like to thumbs up 343 for putting that in, because it's awesome. A big part of today's episode was hubris and underestimating your opponent and how that can make you lose, which is very interesting because that's one of the reasons the Covenant lost the war against the humans, because they underestimated humans. They thought humans were super weak and couldn't do this, and then one of the reasons they lost many battles against humans as well. They won many battles, but they lost a few of them too. They played Capture the Flag. I thought it was a little fun nod to multiplayer, I don't know. Again, lots of emotion. Lasky and this other kid get into a fight in the cafeteria, and then his mother comes in, yells at him, tells him he can be great, and inside he's great. His teachers know he's great, she knows he's great, the officers around the facility know he's great, it's just that he has to know he's great, which is, you know,
you should believe in yourself, everybody. Believe right here that you can do it.
That's pretty cheesy. But yeah, that goes back to the emotion thing. He doesn't want to be there, which is why he doesn't believe in himself. He's still questioning why they're doing this and why they had to fight these other people that just want their freedom. And which brings me to my next point. Sorry, I'm looking down my notes. Changers need followers. So Thomas Lasky wants to make this change. He does want to keep fighting the insurrectionists, and he wants to make peace with them, but he can't do it on himself. By himself. Yeah. He needs people to follow him, and that's the only way he's going to be able to change things as a whole. And that's pretty much all I wanted to say, though I thought something I was finally... at the end of the first video, we kind of saw a Covenant ship moving through space. I thought, oh, maybe this video will have some Covenant in it. It didn't, but in the next video, the Covenant are coming. If you watch at the end of the video, you watch the next time, coming up next, I guess. The Covenant are coming, which is awesome, finally, and they attack the facility. There's a bunch of big explosions. I think we're going to see some of Tom's friends get killed. I think that's really going to spur him to do what needs to be done, because now the problem he had was that he was fighting the humans that he didn't want to fight, but now there's these aliens trying to kill all humans, and that's going to make him want to fight, and he's going to become good, like his brother is good and like his mother is good. Oh! Before we go, one more thing I did want to mention is how the video started out, which was awesome. Cortana saying that it's been about four years or something, that she and Chief have been drifting in space, and she said nothing to do with, there are no tasks or anything. So that whole 4 years, she's done nothing but think. And for those of you who know smart AIs and RapidC, one of the things that spurs that on a lot quicker is having time to think. And she's had 4 years. Smart AIs usually last about 7 years before they come rampant. We know by the time Halo 4 comes out, she's 8 years old, I believe. So she's already past that benchmark. She's going to start going rampant soon, probably. I'll just explain RapidC for those of you who don't know. There are two kinds of AI. There are smart AIs and dumb AIs. Dumb AIs, they're still smart about one subject, but they can't learn any more than they already know, and they can't really think. Like, if you ask the smart AI to make up a story about a dog, it couldn't do that. But if you ask a dumb AI to make up a story about a dog, I screwed that up. But a smart AI, they can learn and grow, and one of the problems with that is after a certain amount of time, a few things can happen. They become rampant, which means a couple things. I think about three or four things can happen. One, they start thinking, well, look how smart I am. I'm an ultra-advanced AI. Why am I taking orders from these lowly humans? You know, that old AI thing that's in pretty much every kind of science fiction that has AI in it. Two, a similar thing, they can start realizing that no matter how smart they become, they'll never be human, and they start wondering, like, what's the point of going on if all I can be is just a bunch of ones and zeros? And a third thing that can happen is they just keep growing and growing and getting too big for the system they're housed in. And if they just kept learning and learning, they'd need an infinitely large system to be housed in, so that wouldn't work, an infinitely large data network. Which, as I'm sure you know, nothing can be infinitely large. That's about it. Foundation Afro. See you next week, and please subscribe for more if you like what you're seeing. Thank you.